For advanced users, you'd want more customizability, and here's how. Have a look at the scene lister. At the end of each scene, there's a small arrow. It's actually a button. You can click on it to expand to advanced settings menu. By looking at these settings, I think you'd have a pretty good idea what they do, but let me explain anyway. The first tab on the top shows you which scene ID and scene name that you're working on. Next is environment and background. The M button is the browser. I'm clicking on it to open the texture browser, and then I can pick something. In this case, fall off. These two little arrows are the tricky part. The left arrow pointing in the slot brings the texture into the slot. The right arrow pointing out of the script drops the texture from the slot to the material editor. Let me show you. Here I have a falloff texture in my slot. All I have to do is to select any slot in the material editor and click the right arrow to drop it into the material editor. If the material editor is not open, it will open it for you and drop the texture into the selected slot. Now let's try the left arrow. Here in the material editor, I have this hdri overcast that I want to use as my environment. What I have to do is to select the hdri and then click the left arrow to bring it into my environment slot. Let's try again. Reset the material editor slots, then click the right arrow. Voila! It's in the material editor. Now you can adjust it to what you want. And yes, this will also work with Slate Material Editor. I'm changing to Slate now. Now try the right arrow. Boom! It's here. Let's say that I want a new texture to be my environment. Let's just pick something. Fall off? Again? Why not? Now drop it into the V1. Double click to select it. And then the left arrow to bring it into the slot. Voila! It's that simple. If you want to remove it, just right click on the M button. For the viewport background, choose whatever you desire. Solid, gradient, image, or environment. By the way, if you select the image, you're gonna want to choose the image directory from the browser below. Next, lighting tab. If you don't like the idea of multiple suns and dome lights like what I did, you can try this feature. First, I check the box to enable it, then click the pick sun button and choose your sun. Now if you uncheck the box, your sun will turn off. Same goes for the dome light. Check the box and then choose the light. Now if you uncheck it, the light will be turned off too. The browser here is the one that will be used in the dome. So you can switch between HDRIs, but only use one dome. And these arrows work the same way as the environment slot. For Corona and other renderers, you won't see the dome light settings because you don't have it and you don't need it. Last tab, render presets. You're saying that man is good but it's not good enough. I want more customization. Try here. Make your own render presets and save it as a preset somewhere. Load it into the slot, it will work. Three things that you need to know. First, the render preset will be the last thing to load from the load button, which means that any settings that you make in the preset will override the settings here in the scene lister. Second, by using the advanced settings, you are creating a new object. It's just a simple plane with one polygon, mainly just to hold the texture. It's called scenelister text holder object in the man scenelister layer, which is hidden and frozen. Last, the script is completely free. I hope you guys enjoy using it. And if you have any question, leave it in the comment section. If you have any bug or if it doesn't work in any way, you can email me. I'll try to fix it. Thanks for watching. Goodbye, people.